There is no secret that I love Kingdom Hearts music. Say what you want about the series as a whole, but one thing that is undeniable is that the series has some of the best music of any media. The amount of emotion that some tracks can bring out and the upbeat compositions, the dark and eerie scores, I'm getting chills just thinking about it. I love Kingdom Hearts music so much that I decided to fly to Atlanta, Georgia to enjoy the Kingdom Hearts Orchestra and Symphony. I would tell you guys right now, that experience is worth every dollar spent. But now we have Melody of Memory. Think of this as a celebration of all the music that the series has blessed us with over a decade. But that's not all. There are also some story elements here that we can go over. Let's get into it. So Kingdom Hearts has a very interesting history of delivering story elements through different forms of gameplay. Of course, you have the mainline number games where they play essentially like a hack and slash, but you also have the in-between or side games like Chain of Memories or Recoded. These games have essential story elements to the overarching story, but the gameplay is not everyone's cup of tea. I feel Melody of Memory may not be everyone's cup of tea since it is essentially a rhythm game. So let me say this now. I am not a Kingdom Hearts expert. I understand the very basic story elements, but Kingdom Hearts lore is extremely complex, and I will not do the story a disservice by attempting to summarize it. However, I feel Melody of Memory does a great job in summarizing the key points in the story from Kairi's point of view. If you've never played a Kingdom Hearts title, this game does a great job in explaining the key points in the overarching story. So we also have some cutscene featuring Kairi herself, but I won't really spoil that for those who have not played the game yet. But I love what they did here in order to get players up to speed. Now, the game itself. The game is a rhythm game. The way I describe it is more like an interactive soundtrack. The game features tracks from the entire series, and I was actually shocked on how many tracks they included in this game. Everything from Kingdom Hearts 1 to Dream Drop Distance, all the way to Kingdom Hearts 3 are represented here. It is a celebration of the beautiful music in this series. I kind of compare it to the 3DS titles for Final Fantasy, which were also rhythm games. While playing this, I got so many chills revisiting the soundtrack. Make sure you play this game with a good pair of headphones, because man, there are also boss fights in this game, and I love these. It switches things up just enough to make the gameplay feel fresh. The controls for this game did take a little getting used to, but once you understand the mechanics, it's pretty easy. I'm playing this on the PS4, so you use the L1, the R1, and the X button as your primary action. You occasionally use the triangle button to cast spells. You don't control the movement of the characters themselves, they're all on rails. This game can get pretty intense on higher difficulties, and it would definitely test your hand-eye coordination. You can also use items that you obtain to give yourself a slight advantage during the gameplay. Now, you start the game off as Sora, Donald, and Goofy, but as you play more through the main story, you unlock more teams to use. I personally like Aqua, Vin, and Terra, since Birth by Sleep is my favorite game in the entire series. These characters are strictly cosmetic and has no bearing in the story or alter the gameplay. You can even use these teams online as well. This game also has a leveling system which can help give you a slight edge during the gameplay, an item and synthesis feature so you can unlock different goodies like player cards for online matches and much more, and if you're a fan of Kingdom Hearts, there's plenty of fan service to consume here, so go out and enjoy this. This game also has a versus mode, which features an online mode. I will say this now, the online mode will be something I'll be playing for a while. I love this mode so much, it kind of reminds me of those old arcade style games. You and your opponent are fighting for that high score and it gets super intense. You also have this trick meter that you can fill up and it will try to disrupt your opponent's progression. I love this. So the question is, should you play this game? Well, I love it so much, so my answer would be yes. This game is a little steep in its asking price of $60, so I would say maybe wait for a sale on this, but if you're a diehard Kingdom Hearts fan and you love the music of the series, this game is a no-brainer and this game is for you. The beautiful soundtrack, the addicting gameplay, the intense arcade-like online makes this game a fun time. Thank you all for watching and I'll see you next time.